good morning. And for those of you who are listening to the sound of my voice, we had an opportunity to witness a miracle. And this morning, my prayer goes out to the families and to the lives of the passengers that only through the blessing of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ for sparing the 130 lives and giving them a second chance, for those who was on Colombia Jetliner Aries plane crash on Monday, August 16, 2010. And as we know, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. For God did not send the Son into the world to judge the world, but that the world should be saved through him, as stated in John 3:16-17. And therefore, having been justified by faith, may you have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom you have obtained your introduction by faith into his grace, in which you stand, and you exalt in hope of glory of God. And not only this, but you also exalt in your tribulation, knowing that tribulations brings about peace and hope, and that peace and hope is proving character, and proving character sustain your faith. And your faith does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured out within your heart through the Holy Spirit, who was given to you as Romans 5:1-5. You may be afflicted in every way, but not crushed, perplexed, but not despairing, prosecuted, but not forsaken, struck down, but not destroyed, knowing that he who raised the Lord Jesus will raise you also with Jesus, and will present your mind, body, and most important, your soul with him. And therefore, you should never lose heart, but through your inner flesh is decaying, yet your inner soul is being renewed day by day. And for momentary light of affliction is producing for you an eternal weight of glory far beyond all comparisons. And while you look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen, for the things which are seen are temporarily, but the things which are not seen are eternal. As in 2 Corinthians 4:8-9, 14:16-18. And as your fragile lives was in the hands of God Almighty on Monday, August 16, 2010, it is because of his blessing in sending his angels to hold on to your precious soul and lives as this plane came to a halt. For the one who suffered from injuries as you lay your body down for healing by hospital staff and physicians, may your Lord Jesus Christ be near you to defend you, within you to refresh you, around you to preserve you, before you to guide you, behind you to justify you, above you to bless you. And you shall live and reign and reign with the Father and the Holy Ghost for all the remaining days of your life. And our Father, as Christians, we thank you for being gracious to your children in Christ, and according to thy loving kindness, and according to the greatness of thy compassion. And they thank you for your help, Father, and they may be perplexed and afraid during the jetliner Aries landing, but God, it was your will and grace that extended the years to your children on this plane. God, I ask you to send your angels to help open the eyes to all that you are still God. And as the wounded bodies of your children are being healed, help their families as they lay their prayer of thanks, love, and understanding that it was your Son, Jesus Christ, who paid the price for our suffering while here on earth. Oh, merciful God, how could we make it without you? Oh, merciful God, for the one lives that was perished from this jetliner plane. Oh, merciful Father, we ask that you lift the burdens of the family of this loved one and help her loved ones, oh, Heavenly Father, to understand, Father, that you are the way, the truth, and the life. And, oh, merciful Father, we just thank you for this day. Thank you for giving them a second chance, oh, Heavenly Father. It could have not been done without your will, oh, Heavenly Father. We thank you, Father. We thank you for each and every day that you allow us to wake up to just praise your holy name. And this we ask in your Son Jesus' name. Thank you, oh, Heavenly Father, letting everyone around the globe of this world to see, Father, that you are and you always will be the marvelous God. Amen. Amen.